just say he raped you twice? Why didn't you tell the cops?
Because he'd say that he didn't have to force me the second time. See, the second time, I let him do it. Just gonna stand there. Aren't you gonna yell at me or anything?
The other day, when you were talking about us wanting to start a family, you knew you were pregnant then, didn't you? What were you trying to do to me? Make me think it was mine.
I was gonna get rid of it.
Yeah, but only after I said that we ought to wait. If I'd said okay, you'd let me go on thinking I was the father, wouldn't you?
No.
Wouldn't you?
No. Well, I thought about it for a second. But I was real scared, Kevin. I didn't know if you'd understand or not.
You didn't even give me a chance, Doreen. You know, and the next thing I know that you're telling me you were raped. Was that a story too?
No!
Well, what am I supposed to think? I mean, one minute you tell me you're raped, the next thing you never forced you at all.
You weren't listening. It was only later on that I said...
I could have killed that guy. You know that? I could have killed him for what he did to you. Because I believed you.
I wasn't lying, honest. Well, not about him raping me anyhow. And I only went along with him the other time so that you'd get that delivery job.
What job?
The one I rang you about, and you would have got it too, except Mrs. Davidson put a stop to it. I had to find out what all the others were offering so that you could put in the best bid.
Do you mean that you did that with him, to get me a job?
Well, you said you weren't doing too good.
Is that what you think of me, that I'm so bloody useless I can't even find my own work?
Well, Doreen doesn't think that, Kevin. Surely you must know that.
Oh, yeah, all right. All right, Mr. Jackson, you all seem to know her better than I do. Are you saying that the next time I'm out of work or things get a bit rough, she's not going to do the same thing again?
How can you say that? I wouldn't.
Well, I don't know when you're telling me the truth anymore, Doreen.
What do you mean, Kevin? Don't you believe me? Well, bugger you then. If that's the way you feel, I never want to see you again.
It's hard enough in the first few months of marriage at the best of times, but when you're separated...
Look, what are you saying, Mrs. Jackson, that I'm wrong?
No, what I'm saying is that you need a lot more understanding and patience.
Oh, I've tried that ever since I met her.
You knew it wasn't going to be easy.
Yeah, but it's the way she went about it. I mean, doesn't she know when she's lying anymore? You might be used to that sort of thing around here, but I'm not. I don't know if I can take it anymore.
Can't be easy for him.
They've been through more than most people have in a lifetime.
Could you bring Doreen to my office, please? I think it's time I had a word with her. Oh, and keep an eye on White. I've sent her back with the other women.
Liz, are you playing this game or not?
Aye.
I asked you for three cards. Oh, listen, Doreen and Kevin have got to sort this out for themselves, and worrying about it is not going to help.
I thought you said they'd chuck her in solitary.
She must have more of a gift of the gab than I thought. Made mincemeat of you every time.
Only because she catches me off guard.
I think we should call it a truce. What do you say, Margo? You only have to put up with me for a few more days, just until my trial. So no more trouble, okay?
You're the one that needs to remember that.
You're not gonna let her get up.
Hey, door. What you sitting over there all by yourself for? Did you work everything out? Did you talk about what you're gonna do with the baby? Then what did you talk about?
Told him the truth and he never believed me.
What'd I tell you, bloody men? The minute you mention rape, they think it has to be the woman's fault. Now, if you'd done as I told you and told him it was his, you'd be all right now.
Look, if I hadn't listened to all of you in the first place, I wouldn't have gotten so mixed up. Now he thinks I'm a rotten little liar.
Now, just let's back up a minute. If anybody gave you advice, it's because you asked for it. Or because they care for you.
And my door, Kev really loves you.
Told him I never want to see him again.
Door!
But I'm gonna see him tomorrow and tell him I never meant it. He's gotta believe me.
God, did your day release come through?
No.
Then would you mind telling us what's going through that thick skull of yours?
I'm going over the fence. And nobody's gonna stop me.
It was real easy last time we got over the fence. You might even be back before they missed you.
Yeah, all we got to do is keep the screws busy.
And I'm going to go with you, Dor. Just make sure Kevin listens to you.
What do you think you're all doing for crying out loud? I've been trying to talk some sense into the girl, and you're all egging her on. Look, you have done nothing but talk to him. Do you think he's going to thank you for breaking out just so you can go over old ground?
Yeah, it'll be different this time. At least we won't have a screw breathing down our necks, and it'll just prove to him how much I love him. Anyhow, we'll only be gone a couple of hours.
Even if it's only for a couple of seconds, you break out, you'll get another 6 months. Now, what good is that going to do your marriage?
Yeah, Dor. We want you to stay together. We don't want you to break up.
Well, thank you, Lizzie. At last, I'm getting through to someone.
Yeah, but if he doesn't believe me and I lose him, I may as well be stuck in here.
Listen, honey. You know, when Noeline was knocked up in that storeroom, well, we got her out of there, and that took over 12 hours. I mean, we won't even be gone that long. It'll be a breeze.
Yeah, Bea. Please, I'll never ask anything of you again.
Yeah, Bea. It might not be as tough as you reckon.
I don't believe this. I mean, I really don't believe it.
I think you should all believe in what you see. You got a point there, Kay.
Mrs. Davidson wants to see you, Doreen.
Mrs. Jackson, look, we all know Doreen's got a few problems. Is there any chance of her getting a day release tomorrow?
Well, that's up to Mrs. Davidson.
But couldn't you put a good word in for her?
I can't promise anything, B.
Okay, what's the big idea?
Just want to help the kid, you know, see she gets back in time.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I'm all heart.
No, the department has not approved your application yet, Doreen.
But you could hurry him up, couldn't you, Mrs. Davidson?
Under the circumstances, I don't think that would be wise. At the moment, you and Kevin are under a great deal of emotional strain.
Yeah, but that's only because we haven't talked things out properly.
You have already had more than your allowed number of visits, Doreen, and to date, they have only aggravated the situation.
It might be best to let things settle down. I mean, if you saw him now, it could make matters worse.
I know what you've been going through these last few days, and I'm very proud of the way you've been coping. I am also aware that you and Kevin have a big decision ahead of you. Now, there are grounds for an abortion, but I think it's important that you both have time alone to think about it. Perhaps then you might be able to discuss it calmly. Do you think that makes sense?
Yeah.
Very well. You may go. It might do some good if I had a word with Kevin myself.
Well, it's worth a try, because every time Doreen tries to explain, it sounds horrifying. I wonder Kevin's confused. They both are.
You know, David could be right.
I'm going to make it up to him, Bea. Well, he's got to know that I'll do anything he says. And if he wants me to have that baby, then I'm having it, and I don't care whose it is.
You really mean that, love?
I just don't want Kevin hating me.
Hey, will you give Josie a ring in hospital while you're out?
Knock it off, will you, Lizzie? You've got 4 hours. You go straight there and back, and no detours. And don't you dare be 1 second late.
How are we going to stop the screws from finding out?
Now, how the hell should I know that? You're the ones that think up these harebrained schemes. They expect me to get you out of them.
Oh, you'll think of something. B, you always do.
Oh, yeah.
It's okay. Jude will look after me.
You're taking quite a risk, aren't you? Surely Doreen can do it on her own.
Well, I just want to see that Kevin talks to her and she gets back on time.
And what about you?
What about me?
Something tells me you've got other plans, and they don't include getting back in time. Not that I blame you. Thank God I'll be out of here in a few days.
You seem pretty sure of yourself.
I have to be. If I thought I was going to be stuck in this place, I'd
go mad. You know something, Kay? You better watch out for yourself. You put on too good an act, you're liable to end up in a padded cell.
They're only treating me for compulsive gambling.
Yeah. Well, what are you going to do when the screws tell the doctor that you've been bashing up Margo?
Out on the board, the old sheriff stands, clutching his shears in his old bony hands, fixes his gaze on a blue-belly Joe. Glory if he makes it to make the ring a go. Click, go the shears, boys, click, click, click. Glory, 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 glory,
The ringer looks around and is beaten by a blow and curses the old snagger with the beverage jar.
Never fails.
Okay, but 10 minutes between lunch and work. As soon as the fight starts, you two could get cracking.
Yeah, it'd be nice if we had something to change into. You could have one of my outfits. Yeah, well, it'd have to stretch. And I mean stretch. That's what I meant, if you wanted to cut it up.
Well, take it.
How are you going to cover for us, B?
Well, you're pregnant, right? Suffering from morning sickness and dizzy spells. And Jude's heart still plays up every now and then. So if anyone asks, you're in the sick bay resting up. We'll just have to cross our fingers that no one checks up.
Sounds good.
If you haven't got enough time to patch it up with Kevin, that's stiff luck, love. Because you both have to be back here. And inside by 4 o'clock. That's when we'll be keeping the screws busy again.
Well, I don't reckon anything could go wrong with that.
I've been over and over it, Mrs. Davidson. Something's happened, you know. It's like, bit by bit, something's dying. I just don't think it's going to come back.
You still care about her. That's important.
Yeah, but I'd just always be thinking she was lying to me.
Kevin, I've known Doreen a long time. Oh, there's a distance between inmates and those in authority. But I wouldn't be here if I didn't believe in her. It's not so very long ago that Doreen felt whenever she became close to someone, they either left or something happened. You changed all that. You made her feel she had a future. And for the first time in her life, she didn't feel she belonged in prison.
She still went back there, though. See, Mrs. Davidson, I just feel like I haven't been any good to her at all, you know? Like, okay, when we first met, I could understand why she was afraid to tell me the truth. I didn't care that she'd been inside. I almost lost my family because I wanted to marry her. Well, it just seems to me that now she's making the same mistakes all over again, you know? How many times am I supposed to go through all this?
That's when believing in someone comes in.
Well, you believe in her. Look, I just don't know anymore.
Then you'll have to tell her that. And soon. Could you come to my office today, say about 12:30? I think I should be there when you talk to her.
Yeah.
Don't know why you had to get the material from her. She's only sucking up to you so you won't get back at her for lying into me.
Well, you volunteered to get her into strife?
Yeah, well, I wouldn't trust her as far as I could throw her.
Which hasn't been very far. Before you do anything stupid, Jude, we didn't get very far last time you decided to go walkabout.
Where do you think I'm going to go? Back home to my loving family?
Oh, don't forget we're taking that out as well.
Yeah. Be rotten if you got your knickers hooked on the wire.
Lizzie, have you finished work?
Quick. Hi, Mrs. J. Just want to stretch my legs a bit.
Good, because I think I can help you out. You can serve morning tea in the staff room and then help set up for lunch.
Oh, but I wanted to go...
You were saying?
Nothing.
Doreen, are you all right?
Oh, yeah, I just feel a bit dizzy. That's all, Mrs. Jackson. I'd be all right if I could get some fresh air.
Well, if you don't feel any better, you report to dispensary.
Oh, thanks.
Well, I don't want my file to have too many black marks against it, so I thought I'd make up for a few of my mistakes.
If you've got something to say, say it.
There's going to be an escape.
Let's see what this is going to achieve, Vera. If you're so sure they're going to escape, then we should try to prevent it, not encourage it. Besides, they won't make an attempt if they know they're being watched.
The only way to prevent it is to catch them red-handed.
Anything I can do?
Thanks. But I think it's about time we made our move. Long now.
Hey, dog, you want to hear something funny?
You love this.
the hell?
Seems your information was wrong.
We'll soon see about that.
Oh, do you want to hear a joke, Miss Bennett? Oh, prune!
Getting rid of the bed bugs, Miss Bennett.
You're not in the dining room in 1 minute. You won't get any lunch at all.
I wonder what got into Vinegar.
As if you didn't know.
I don't like being made a fool of, White.
I don't know what happened.
God, that was close. I thought we'd never make it.
Yeah, thanks, Lizzie.
I could kill her for that.
We're not going to let on, we know.
Doreen?
Kevin's here to see you.
Oh, you mean it?
He's waiting in my office. Mrs. Jackson, would you make sure that Doreen's lunch is kept for her, please?
Yes, of course. Hurry up, everybody. We haven't got all day.
Oh. Kay hadn't lagged. I don't know what we would have done. She'd done us a favour and we didn't know it.
Yeah, but the point is, she did go to the screws. No one's getting away with that.
Oh, Kevin, I'm sorry. I never meant to yell at you. I've been going out of my mind. I thought you'd never want to see me again. I swear I'll never do anything like that to you again. I know I hurt you, but I never meant to, and it won't happen again. You just tell me what to do, and I'll try real hard. I'll make it up to you.
Doreen.
I love you, Kevin, and whatever I did was for you, even if it was wrong.
Doreen, look, please, listen to me, will you?
Look, I don't think that's all. You know what I'm like, but I'll change. I'll be whatever you want.
Yeah, but I don't want you to be what I want. I want you to be what you want. You know, I shouldn't have to tell you what to do or how to think. It ought to just be there.
Yeah, well...
You'd better sit down, Doreen.
Cool.
I know what you're going to say. You don't want me to have the abortion. Well, that's all right. I won't, Kevin. Whatever you say.
Yeah, well, you know, that's something you're going to have to sort out for yourself now, Dor.
But you told me not to get rid of it, even if it was somebody else's.
Yeah, well, if you have it, I suppose you could adopt it out.
But I know what it's like not to have a mother to bring you up properly.
Well, then keep it.
But I don't want to have his baby. I want it to be ours.
Well, I'm trying to tell you that that's something you're going to have to figure out for yourself.
But why?
Because I'm not going to be around.
Well, if you don't want to have anything to do with it, I'll understand, really.
Look, I want a divorce, Doreen. We can't go on like this. I'm not helping you. I never have. There's no other way.
Don't you love me anymore?
I only know it isn't working. You know, every time we get things sorted out, something goes wrong. We're just tearing each other apart. We only end up hating each other.
I'd never hate you.
Dor, I can't handle it, you know? I can't take the responsibility. I don't want to be your keeper. That's not what marriage is all about. It's about respecting each other. It's about being honest with each other. I want to be your husband. I can't be your father. I'm sorry.
You've got nothing to be sorry about. It's me. I've messed it all up. You've been real good to me, Kevin. More than anyone else ever. I don't want to go ruining your life like everything else. Anyway, it's pretty good that we're splitting up while we still love each other, eh? Can I go now, Mrs. Davidson?
You'd better report to Mrs. Jackson.
Look after yourself.
Yeah, you too.
Dear B, Lizzie and Judy. I've really gone and done it this time. You've always been friends. Family. And I keep letting you down too. I never meant to, but I reckon I'm just no good. I love you all. Hope you understand.
Bell Burns.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Then what are you doing in here? Daydreaming about getting out?
I just wanted to be by myself for a while.
You can't be trusted on your own for more than 2 minutes. Now get moving.
I'm feeling sick, Miss Bennett.
A little bit of morning sickness isn't going to kill you. And just because Mrs. Davidson's been good enough to allow you far too many visits from your husband doesn't mean that you can take advantage of the rest of us.
He's not coming anymore.
Well, I'm amazed that he bothered for so long, especially after all the trouble you got yourself into.
Can I go to the loo, Miss Bennett? I'm going to be sick.
Oh, very well. Get moving. Are you all right, Doreen? Mrs. Davidson told me what happened. I'm sorry. You up to seeing Miss Forster?
Yeah, I am.
I thought I'd leave Butchie at home today. I'm certain he's running a temperature, and cat fever can be very serious. Are you sure you don't want any tea, Mrs. Jackson?
No, thank you, Miss Forster.
Oh, then perhaps you'd care to wait outside while I have a little chat to Doreen.
I'd rather stay here, thank you.
Oh, you're entitled. Sit down, dear. Sit down.
What do you want to see me about?
Well, I didn't want you to think that I'd forgotten about you, so I'm just letting you know that although the department haven't yet approved of your day release, I'll still keep pestering them.
Miss Forster?
It's okay, Mrs. Jackson. You're too late.
Oh, well, I take it that you and Kevin have sorted out what you're going to do with your child.
Yeah, I'm getting rid of it.
Now, listen to me, my girl. We've had this out before. If you're going against your husband's wishes,
Miss Forster,
I'll see that he takes out a court order against it.
You stupid old bag!
Doreen, no!
If I could have got out in time, he mightn't have left me. But
come on,
oh, no, you couldn't get off your butt to put in my application. You bloody old bitch!
Why didn't you warn me? The last I heard, Kevin was going to talk to her about keeping their child.
Now, that was days ago, Miss Forster. And if you'd been keeping up with the reports, you'd know by now that the baby isn't Kevin's, that Doreen's pregnant because she was raped. And if you'd given me half a chance to explain, not half an hour ago, Kevin told her he wanted a divorce.
Well, I should have been informed.
You were, by the reports.
Oh, I've dozens of reports to read. All it would have taken was one simple telephone call from any one of you. I'm well aware the staff don't like me, Mrs. Jackson. Mr. Fletcher warned me. But if you're trying to prove it, I'm not doing my job. It'll take more than that to get rid of me.
Are you sure you don't want to see the sister? She could give you something to settle you down.
I'm okay, Mrs. Jackson. Just don't want anyone feeling sorry for me, that's all. You know, I never even knew what it was like to be married. We had the wedding and that was it. Never even lived together. Guess I was lucky in a way. Not getting used to it, and then losing him.
Doreen, if you ever feel, well, that you can't stand it in here, will you come and talk to me? It'd be silly to end up with a further sentence.
Oh, I've got no reason to want to get out now. Mrs. Jackson, you won't tell Bea or the others about this, will you? I'd like to tell them myself.
Of course.
You've been a real good friend to me.
I hope I still am.
Oh, yeah. It's just that I think you're great, you know. And a lot of the women would have had a much harder time in here if it wasn't for you.
Oh, how'd you go, love?
What do you have to say for himself? Well, everything went real well.
Oh.
He just said it was a misunderstanding.
Oh, I knew Kevin'd come good. You've got yourself a real man there, Doreen.
Yeah, I take back everything I said. He's okay. Good on you, love.
Okay, everyone, let's get back to business.
We're taking a vote on what to do about Kay.
Can't we just forget about it?
Oh, well,
I mean, if Jude and I had got out with Kevin coming to see
but
me...
But if Lizzie hadn't found out in time, you two would have been up for another 6 months. That dame wouldn't have given two hoots if you'd got extra time.
Come on, let's vote.
We're not rushing this, Margot. I mean, it's not the same as talking about clobbering someone or having them shoved in solitary. We are talking about having someone put inside.
Listen, she got 7 days taken off our remissions, remember? I say we show her what it's like knowing you've got to serve time.
Well, how are we going to do that?
Well, her trial's tomorrow, isn't it? She's going to get her head shrinker to tell the court to let her off because she's been a good little girl who's looking after herself.
All we got to do is get him to change his mind.
You know, we've never done this before, and I hope to hell we never have to do it again. We all know what it means, being locked up. So let's be very sure of one thing. Let's just make sure she deserves it. And I mean, really deserves it.
Anyway, she could still get off, couldn't she? We're just going to cut her chances down a bit.
Hmm. Oh, short of killing her, there's nothing else left.
Okay, all those in favour. Well, the majority has it. Lizzie, you are going to start the ball rolling.
Well, as far as I know, Eric has been onto the department to see if they can get her transferred, but they don't seem interested. Stupid woman. It's the last thing Doreen needed.
But Burns is tough. She'll wallow in self-pity for a few days just to get the sympathy, and then she'll be out to cause trouble.
Forget I ever mentioned it.
Well, I knew as soon as they got married it'd be a disaster. He seems decent enough, I suppose, but look at her past record. In and out of institutions most of her life. For prostitution, forgery, robbery. Well, he must have been simple to think that all that would change.
You really are most understanding, Vera.
I'm realistic. She's a conniving little criminal. And you can't tell me she wasn't about to escape before Birdsworth interfered.
I wouldn't exactly trust everything Kay White said either.
Oh, don't worry. I'm on to her little games. She better tread pretty carefully from now on.
I just mean to see Miss Forster. You're a bit hard on her, weren't you, Meg?
Not particularly. I merely filled her in with a few facts, which by rights she should have known.
Oh, come off it. You've all been trying to keep her in the dark ever since she arrived here.
Look, the prisoners aren't overly fond of her either.
Oh, it's no wonder. They probably sense how the staff feel about her. They'd love to keep us at loggerheads.
Jim, she's in a responsible position. As far as I can see, she's done more harm than good. Besides, was it necessary to tell her we're trying to get rid of her?
Well, why not? It was the truth, wasn't it?
Look, it's not only us, Mr. Fletcher. Mrs. Davidson feels the same way.
Yes?
Do you mind if I clear away now, please, Mr. Fletcher?
Do what you like, Lizzie.
Would you like to go through these rosters now? Meadows, 8 to 4.
Phillips, 4 to 12. Knox, 12 to 8. Mr. Fletcher will be on the 8 to 4 shift. Right, they're all the officers of the day. I'll just run through the others. On the 8...
Oh, sorry.
Hurry up, Birdsworth. On the 8 to 4 shift, starting on the 11th, there'll be Bennett, Jackson, Powell and Barry. Birdsworth!
Oh, didn't mean to touch it. I'm just finding out whose it was.
Don't be ridiculous. You'll find yourself on loss of privileges because of this.
I wasn't going to take anything, Mrs. Jackson. I've just got to lay my hands on some money, that's all. Otherwise, she'll kill me and I'll be in terrible trouble.
What sort of trouble?
You'll be in more trouble if you don't tell us.
Well, it's that Kay White. I don't want to lag on her or anything.
Look, I won't tell you again.
Well, she's been running this poker school for the last couple of nights. We only play for fun, you know, but she's a real gambler. And she bids very high stakes, and I'm into her for a lot of money. And you know what a bad temper she's got and how strong she is. Well, she reckons that if I don't pay her, I'm going to be a goner. And I don't know what to do, Miss Bennett.
What's the matter?
Now, why should anything be the matter?
Just getting our stake for tonight's game, that's all.
What game?
Poker. We're celebrating. It's going to be a big night.
Oh, what have you got to celebrate?
Well, Kevin and me, we're back together. If we had got out like we were meant to, well, we'd have botched things up real good and proper.
Yeah, and it sure gave me a hell of a scare, I can tell you that. It's the last time I'll do anything on the spur of the moment.
Do you know what went wrong?
Some of your lady luck must have rubbed off on us. If Lizzie hadn't spotted Vera in time, we would all have been hung, drawn and quartered.
Do you mean she just happened to be there?
That's right. Good old reliable Vera the Vulture.
Oh, you were lucky, weren't you?
Hey, why don't she join us tonight?
No, thanks. I don't want Vera catching me.
You think we'd play if we hadn't thought that one out?
Besides, I haven't got anything to play with.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You gave me all your buy-up, didn't you? Well, I'll tell you what. I'll stake you. I'll give you half back. If you win, you can pay me back.
Thanks.
See you at the game.
If the screws aren't going to raid until halfway through the game, they'll confiscate the stakes.
It'll be worth it. Just make sure you don't hold back on the bets, otherwise she's going to get suspicious.
You don't have to do all this for me.
It's for all of us, love.
Yeah, I know. But you've always looked after me, Bea. You're the best friend I ever had.
Will you get those out of here?
What?
We're not playing with marked cards. This is legit. For crying out loud, get us a clean deck, will you, Lizzie? Get those out of here.
Oh.
She'd pick that in a minute.
Hey, Dor, you sure you don't want to play?
Nah, I'd rather watch.
All right.
Lizzie, when I get out of here, Kevin and I thought we might go away for a while, you know, to start on a fresh foot.
Are you going to sell your house?
Oh, no, we'd probably rent it, but I was wondering how you'd get out, you know, on your own, you know, without having us around.
Oh, I won't be on my own. Once Josie gets over her complications, I'll have all my
Lizzie,
own family.
Will you stop yakking and get that pack of cards?
All set.
Raring to go. There you go. I have counted it.
I haven't.
Highest card deals.
We're all seeing you.
Full hand on aces.
Oh,
what? You should have seen what I had.
Well, I think I'll call it a day.
Oh, no, you don't. Not when you're so far ahead.
I don't want to push my luck. I mean, if the officers come in.
That's weird. Oh. very nice. Deal up.
I'll see you and raise you.
I'll raise you 50. Go.
What are you doing?
I told you not to go up against a pro, but oh no, you wouldn't listen to me, would you?
Well, I've got to get some of this back.
So this is how you stay out of trouble, is it, White?
You bitch. You've done it again.
No, you don't, White.
You're lying.
I think we can believe our own eyes. Take that back, Birdsworth. Where's Doreen?
Probably got bored.
Sure she's all right? Why wouldn't she be?
Happy as a pig in mud.
Kevin wants a divorce. Didn't she tell you?
Oh, my God.
We've got to find her. Look, none of you women are going anywhere.
Not now, Vera, I'm not in the mood.
Come on, wife.
Burns, will you love her and respect her, be honest with her and stand by her whatever may come, so you can genuinely share your lives together?
I will.
Doreen May Anderson, will you love him and respect him, be honest with him and stand by him whatever may come, so you can genuinely share your lives together?
I will.
Nothing.
This is how you take care of your own.
All right, White. Let's go.
Do you know what you've done to me?
Come on.
We should have known what was the matter with Dor.
Yeah. Instead, we were too busy playing funny buggers.
Kevin is coming here.
Oh, thank heavens. It could be a new start. Oh, I feel so responsible. That poor girl. If only she'd told me how she felt.
Did you try to find out?
Pardon?
Well, it seems the only time you followed up one of the women's problems, you only added to her stress because your information was so much out of date.
You can't blame me for the whole affair.
No, but I do feel you added to the pressure she was under.
I wasn't told the facts until today, and in no uncertain terms by Mrs. Jackson. But no doubt she's already given her side of the story.
I understand written reports were sent to your office earlier.
My advice was sound.
and was given without the full knowledge of Doreen's situation or her state of mind, and because of your own personal feelings on the matter.
My qualifications are above reproach.
Qualifications are of no use unless they are followed by results. To date, that leaves a lot to be desired.
We've all lost someone we love, but we go on. Who knows what's around the next corner? You can't see it now, but there'll be someone else.
Like Kevin.
No. Nothing's ever the same.
I'd only ruin it again anyway.
You will if you go on thinking you will.
I don't want to go on.
You're your own worst enemy, Doreen. Now, that's the coward's way out. It's selfish and it's thoughtless. I thought you were stronger than that. Now, there's a lot of people in here who love you. How do you think they'd have felt if you'd killed yourself, eh? Did you think of that? They'd have had to live with that for the rest of their lives, because you didn't think enough of them to worry as to how they'd feel. Now, what if B or Lizzie or Judy had done the same thing to you?
I've only ever been a burden to them.
If you go on thinking like that, then no one can help you.
I never asked anyone for help.
Then perhaps next time you should. Although I've got enough confidence in you to believe there won't be a next time.
Is she okay?
She's in hospital.
Yeah, and the baby?
Well, as far as I know, nothing happened to it.
But why weren't you keeping an eye on her? You must have known something like this was going to happen.
We're not running a marriage guidance centre.
But somebody's got to take care of her.
You were the one who walked out on her, Mr. Burns.
I had to tell her before she got out. It would have been much harder on her if I'd waited. At least in here she's got some friends. Or I thought she had.
If you men can't cope with knowing the type of girlfriends or wives you end up with, then why marry them in the first place?
Yesterday you were telling me you had no intention of getting into any more trouble.
I meant it.
And yet within 24 hours, you are involved in running a poker game.
That wasn't me.
As far as I can see, you have been using me, Dr. Weissman, and everyone else to gain sympathy at your trial.
That's not true. I'm sick. You don't know what it's like. They wouldn't let me alone. They kept at me to play. It's like handing a bottle of scotch to an alcoholic.
Which you could have refused.
You don't know what it's like. Dr. Weissman does. Why don't you speak to him?
I have every intention of doing just that. Up until now, Dr. Weissman has been under the impression that you have been trying to help yourself.
That's why he's treating me.
Using your own example, an alcoholic, drug addict, or compulsive gambler has to want to be helped. That means meeting the person who is treating you halfway. All you have proven is that you have no intention of rehabilitating yourself. I intend to advise Dr. Weissman of that.
Can I see her alone, please?
I think it'll be all right.
He's been searched.
Doreen. Love, it's me. It's Kevin. Look, if it's not too late, I'd like to try and make it up to you. You know, I'd never have forgiven myself if anything had happened to you. If you want to take me back, well, we can try and work it out.
What do you want to do, Kevin?
Take care of you.
What we had was something real special. Do you reckon it'll ever be the same again? I couldn't look in your face knowing that you only stayed with me because you felt sorry for me. Or you were scared to leave me on my own in case I did something stupid.
What can I do?
Nothing. It's too late. Even I know that. I'll never be any good to anyone till I can try and stand on.
Just sit here for a while.